Fruit Ninja. The idea that a human being can throw a playing card with this kind of power and accuracy is insane to me.
Look at that!
And while throwing cards isn't necessarily my strong suit, I can design and build stuff, so I made the world's first deadly powerful playing card machine gun. So I'm gonna give you a quick overview of the design and performance of my machine. And then to really test it out, I'm gonna go head-to-head, man versus machine in a series of challenges against the best card thrower in the world. Here we go. So to start off, you load a deck of cards in the bottom right here, and then there's really two parts to the gun. First, you wanna slide the cards forward one at a time from the top of the deck underneath. That's what this belt and pulley are for. And by turning this variable resistor, we can adjust the feed speed. And then for the second part, you've got this main wheel with O-rings stretched around that's attached to this brushless DC motor. The cards are pushed under the wheel and it contacts on the left side and it spins them out underneath like this. It works because there's a gap under the spinning wheel that's just barely smaller than the thickness of a single card. And to build it as usual, first we started in CAD, then machined the main body out of aluminum C-channel. After that, it was just a matter of putting it together and running a lot of tests. And so this is what it looks like running in single shot mode. And then machine gun mode. And then Robin Hood mode. And perhaps my favorite part is if you want extra stability, you just push this button. I think I'm happy enough with how it's performing at this point, so now it's time for the real test. And to do that, I tracked down a man who could throw a playing card through just about anything.
Rick Smith Jr.
So how many world records do you hold, Rick?
I hold 3 Guinness Book World Records. Throwing a playing card the farthest, 72 yards, 92 miles an hour, the highest, and considered the most accurate.
All right. So in order to objectively test how good this really is, I am challenging the best the human race has to offer. 3 rounds, man versus machine.
Let's do this.
This is like a metaphor.
Yeah, it is.
How do you feel with all of humanity's hopes and dreams resting squarely on your shoulders?
I'm really worried on this. This is pretty impressive.
I will say it looks, I think, a little more intimidating than it is. This is highly over-engineered.
Is it?
No.
No, I don't think so.
Let's go.
All right.
Round 1, man versus machine.
Okay.
How many cards can you get in the styrofoam in 6 seconds?
6 seconds?
Got plenty of strength.
I got this.
This is a machine gun.
I got it.
Start. And time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
9 in 6 seconds.
I'll time you, ready?
What? I didn't want to introduce this yet, just right out of the gate, but.
What is that?
Go!
Yeah! 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh.
Even though I beat him in the first of our 3 rounds, Rick said he'd show me a few of his trick shots. Round 2.
Are you ready?
Right now, I just want to say, machines 1, humanity 0.
Well, this is about accuracy. Is your machine accurate as it is fast?
Oh. even more accurate than it is fast, but I'll prove that to you. I throw the olive up, one chance.
One chance.
Slice it clean through.
I got it.
Oh!
Whoa!
What?
Long ways.
Wow.
Completely in half.
Am I nervous? No. All right, time for the machine.
Let's go.
Jeez.
I mean, that was close.
That was not close at all.
There's gotta be something there. You switched the olives.
I did not.
You're a magician. Whatever. That's fine. 1-1, I guess.
Oh my god, that scared me. I want you to think of a playing card, any playing card on. Now, we've been playing with cards all day long.
Have, yep.
Awesome. Name that card now.
Ace of Spades.
That's a common card. You sure you want that card?
Yeah.
All right.
This is an Ace of Spades.
Well, that's my business card. I don't know why that's in there. But you really want the Ace of Spades? You can change it if you'd like. I don't want you to be
I do want to change it.
Well, you're changing it.
Yeah, well, you said I
all right, what are you changing it to?
Three of Clubs.
I knew he would. Look at this.
If this
look,
is
look, look,
clubs,
look,
I'm...
You look through the cards like this slowly.
No.
Look, look, look. You'll see that one card and one card only is different. It happens to be the Three of Clubs.
Stop!
Was that it?
What?
So cool.
My mind just broke. I hate you so much.
I'm so sorry.
The world is no longer true. It's witchcraft!
And to help calm my very troubled mind before the final showdown, I decided we should blow some stuff up.
You guys ready?
Woo! Yeah! Oh,
and the physics at play here is pretty straightforward. If you've ever put your hand out the window of a car, you know what happens if you barely angle it up or down. So to fly fast, you want to be perfectly level. There's the sweet spot right in the middle. When I covered the science of the perfect rock skip in another video, we talked about how spinning things are more stable because of Newton's first law. So Rick really flicks his wrist to maximize the card rotation, which keeps it stable and level, slicing through the air much longer than anyone else on the planet.
All right, Rick Smith Jr.
All right, Mark Rober.
This is the last competition.
Okay, what are we doing?
First one to stick it in the watermelon wins.
That should be easy, one try.
There's the one catch, the cool little twist, is what? You have to shoot under the waterfall. Okay?
All right, so you're gonna give us a countdown?
I'll count down. This is it, man versus machine. Is it this over-engineered NASA piece of junk or the collegiate baseball throwing Guinness World Record card thrower? Place your bets in the comments below. Just don't forget to take this into consideration. When I count to three.
On three.
Yep, one, okay. Two.
You're out!
And so while the robot uprising is undeniably marching closer every day, at least for the time being, Rick Smith Jr. has our back. If you want to learn how to throw cards like Rick Smith Jr., he actually put up a tutorial video on his channel. It's actually a super teachable skill, because I started out like this,
And less than 5 minutes later, I was doing this. So go check that out and sub his channel for more cool magic and card trick shots. Rick, could we go maybe a little thinner on those slices, pal? Through just about anything. I wanted another go at it, sorry. I'm too fast for you, dog. I'm too fast for you.